بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. We're with four surahs today. سورة الأنبياء, سورة الحج, and سورة المؤمنون. And they will be covering a little bit just the very beginning of سورة النور. I will not be able to, unfortunately, cover all the surahs. I will leave سورة النور until tomorrow, inshallah تعالى. We'll try to cover some gems on these three amazing surahs. Surah Al-Anbiya, the Prophets. It's a Mecca surah. Surah Al-Hajj is a Madani surah. And Surah Al-Mu'minun is a Mecca surah, which means it was revealed in Mecca. And all of them are from the Mi'in. Yani they are 100 ayat or so, except Surah Al-Hajj, which is only 78 ayat. Let's start with Surah Al-Anbiya. It starts off with Allah Azza wa Jalla talking about al-ba'th, talking about resurrection, talking about the day of judgment. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala says بعد أعوذ من الشيطان الرجيم اقترب للناس حسابهم وهم في غفلة معرضون. اقترب, the hour is near. This was more than 1400 years ago, the Prophet Muhammad Azza wa Jalla. What day is it now in the Islamic lunar calendar? What day is it? 1444, mashallah, you're good. What is the full date, 1444, what? Oh. Ramadan is?
13
Ramadan. 13 Ramadan, 1444. So imagine 44 years ago, the Prophet says, the hour is near. اقترب للناس حسابهم. We're in 2023. I mean, we're today. It was like a long time. This was more than 1,000 years ago. And the Prophet is saying that Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, the hour, people's reckoning is drawing near, and people are fi ghafla. They are in a state of heedlessness. They're not taking this matter seriously. The matter about the day of judgment. Everybody thinks that, you know, we still have time. I'm still young. It's still gonna, you know, it's still have a long way to go. The Prophet is saying, Allah is saying, طلب للناس حسابهم. And then Allah Subhanahu wa Taala says, verse number 10. Here's a gem. Allah Subhanahu wa Taala says, لقد أنزلنا إليكم كتابا فيه ذكركم أفلا تعقلون. We have revealed unto you kitab. In it is your dhikr. In it is your reminder. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, in this kitab is your honor. In this kitab is your grace. In this kitab is Allah Azza wa Jalla, your elevation. What kitab are we talking about here, brothers and sisters? What kitab are we talking about here? Al-Qur'an. We're talking about the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla, Al-Qur'an. The kitab here means the Qur'an. The Quran is Allah Azza wa Jalla has many beautiful names, and one of the names of Allah is Al-Azim. And if Allah is great, Azim, His words are Azim, and the words of Allah are the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jalla, by virtue of this Quran, He will elevate you. Allah Azza wa Jalla, by virtue of this Quran, He will favor you amongst all others. MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. What makes these qaris very special? Because of the Quran they carry in their hearts, in their breast. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate them in this dunya and also in their rank, higher ranks in Jannah, because of the Quran. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says that in the Quran is it in your honor, is your dhikr. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the power of tawakkul, which in this surah, Surah Al-Anbiya, is manifested through the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Amazing. If you want to learn about tawakkul of Allah Azza wa Jal, Surah Al-Anbiya and the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim was young. You know, if you read the tafsir, he was about 16 years old, they said, when he went and he destroyed the idols. In fact, his father used to crowd the idols. So he goes and he destroyed the idols, and then he left the axe that he used in front of the big idol. He destroyed all of them, and then he left one idol, the big one, and he left the axe in front of the idol. Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, verse number 51, إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ وَقَوْمِهِ مَا هَذِهِ التَّمَاثِيلُ الَّتِي أَنْتُمْ لَهَا عَاكِفُونَ. What's this tamathil that you people are worshipping? قَالُوا وَجَدْنَا آبَاءَنَا لَهَا عَاكِفِينَ. We found our forefathers worshipping them, so we're worshipping them. قَالَ قَدْ إِنَّكُمْ كُنْتُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ وَأَبَاءَكُمْ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. You and your parents, you and your forefathers are in a stray. وَتَاللَّهِ لَأَكِيدَنَّ. And he says, by Allah, I shall destroy all of them. So he just, what did he do? He went and he destroyed them. So they came around. They came back finding all these idols being destroyed. So they said, verse number 59, قالوا من فعل هذا بآلهتنا إنه لمن الظالمين. Who said, who did this to our gods, to our idols? Indeed, his wrongdoer. Who did this to our gods? قالوا سمعنا فتى يذكرهم يقال له إبراهيم. We heard of فتى. In Arabic, فتى من الفتوة. فتى means a boy, a young boy, by the name of Ibrahim. قالوا فأتوا به على عيون الناس لعلهم يشهدون. Bring him in front of everybody. Let's ask him, let's question him. So they brought Ibrahim and they said, أنت فعلت هذا بآلهتنا يا إبراهيم؟ Are you the one who did this to our gods, Ibrahim? Are you the one who destroyed them? He says, بل فعله كبيرهم هذا فاسألهم إن كانوا ينطقون. This Kabir, this big guy right here, ask him, look, the axe next to him, why don't you ask him? They said, yeah, this guy's right. فانقلبوا. Then they go back and they said, but you know that they cannot hear, they cannot see. Why are you telling us to ask this guy? He cannot hear, he cannot. He says, how can you worship something that cannot hear, cannot see, that cannot benefit you? أُفِّلْ لَكُمْ لِمَا تَعْبُدُونَ. Oh, to you and to what you worship. And then instead of coming back to the truth, they are persisting in remaining in darkness. What did they say? حَرِّقُوهُ وَانْصُرُوا آلِهَتُكُمْ. حَرِّقُوهُ. In Arabic we say أَحْرَق. You know, when you burn, say أحرق. But here, in صيغة المبالغة, for those who know a little bit about the Arabic نحو, حرقوا, بصيغة المبالغة, in the form of intensity, burn him. يعني they build this huge fire and they throw Ibrahim into it. قال حرقوه وانصروا آلهتكم. And then here is the beauty, another gem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he addressed the fire. And what did he tell the fire? يا نار, O fire. يا نار, كوني بردا بكول. If Allah was to say cool, Ibrahim would have frozen. But Allah says, be cool and salam. Be cool and salam ala Ibrahim. Ya narkuni baradan wa salaman ala Ibrahim. Brothers and sisters, what is the lesson? The fire is a creation of Allah. It burns, but it can only burn with the permission of Allah. The knife that Ibrahim used to sacrifice his son, the knife kills. The knife slaughters. But the knife can only kill with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the power of tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? And then in verse number 76, Allah azza wa jalla talks about the prophets who invoked their Lord, starting from Nuh alayhi salam. And this is a really beautiful lesson to all of us, because we make dua and we want Allah to answer our dua. What is the condition? What is so special about these prophets that Allah azza wa jalla has answered their call? Starting from Nuh alayhi salam. وَنُوحًا إِذْ نَادَانَا إِذْ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلِ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. And Nuh invoked us, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. And we answered his call. And then Allah says, وَأَيُّوبْ وَإِذْ نَادَ رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. And Ayyub, he called upon us and we answered his call. And then وَدَنُّون. Sisters, this question is for you. Wa alaikum salam. وَدَنُّون. Who are we talking about here? Who are we talking about here? وَدَنُّون. I'm sorry? حضرت يوسف. حضرت. You, Yusuf. Yusuf. Yunus. What did she say? Yusuf, right? Okay, give her chocolate. MashaAllah. Yunus alayhi salam, the known. What? Here we go. There's another one. All right, then get the chocolate. وذنون إذ ذهب مغاضبا فظن أن لن نقدر عليه فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين فاستجبنا له. And then Noon, when he left without the permission of the Lord, and you know the story of Yunus alayhi salam, when he was swallowed by the fish. And then he made that dua. Oh Allah, I wronged myself. La ilaha illa anta. I wronged myself. Inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Fastajabna lahu. We answered his call. And then Zakariya, one more time, another prophet making dua to Allah Azza wa Jal. Zakariya, إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ رَبِّي لَا تَذَرَنِي فَرْدًا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. And Zakariya, he was childless and he made that dua to Allah. Oh Allah, don't leave me childless. And you are خَيْرُ الْوَارِثِينَ. You are the supreme inheritor. فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. We answered his call. He answered the call of all of them. Why? Allah Azza wa Jalla answers the call right here. He tells you why. Here's a gem. Remember it, brothers and sisters, if you want Allah Azza wa Jalla to answer the dua. إنهم كانوا يسارعون في الخيرات. They used to rush in doing good deeds. If you want Allah to answer your dua, they used to hasten in doing good deeds. خير. إنهم كانوا يسارعون في الخيرات ويدعوننا رغبا ورهبا. And they used to make, they used to invoke us at all times. If you want your dua to be answered, inshaAllah ta'ala. Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhal nas, uttaqwa rabbakum, inna zalzalat al-sa'ati shay'un ajeeb. Say'u shay'un azeeb. Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about the day of judgment, about the zalzala. And he gave example of this woman. You know, even if a woman is pregnant, she would drop her baby. A woman who's sucking her baby, she would drop her baby. Nobody will care about anybody else. Is that the intensity of that day? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Ibrahim and the story of Ibrahim calling people to Al-Hajj. This is why it was called Surah Al-Hajj. And last but not least, brothers and sisters, Surah Al-Mu'minun. Allahu Akbar. Al-Mu'minun in itself requires seminars. Allah Azza wa Jalla is talking about the ingredients, the recipe for the true success. The recipe for Al-Falah. When the Imam, when the Mu'addin, he says, Hayya ala Al-Falah. You know, hayya, come to the true success. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Indeed, the mu'minun are successful. Who are they? Then Allah Azza wa Jalla is talking about these attributes of these mu'minun. First and foremost, success. Allah says, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. And those who are khush, they build the khushu' in the salah. They pray with solemnity, you know, with khushu' in the salah, with devotion in their salah. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. And those who stay away from vain talk. Brothers and sisters, please. She said, he said, backbiting, backstabbing is not going to add nothing but sins to your bank account of good, of deeds. Leave that. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ. I have no time for this, you know, instant talk, you know, vain talk. لا. You know, fill your time with beneficial talk, with beneficial deeds. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. And those who pay charity. We beg you, please help the masjid, help the centers, help people, inshallah ta'ala. Help us, help others, inshallah ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ. Talking about those spouses, those who guard their chastity. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَعَهْدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. And those who keep their covenants, they keep their promises, they keep their amanat, their trust. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَى صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ. And those who persist in the salah, they keep the salah. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ. الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. Those who will inherit what? الوارثون. They will inherit what will you inherit? They will inherit الفردوس الأعلى إن شاء الله تعالى. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla talks about the stages of man creation, you know, from different stages. And at the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says here, verse number 99, and we'll end with this, inshaAllah ta'ala. حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتِ قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِيمَا تَرَكْتُ. This is a golden reminder for all of us, my brothers and sisters. Coming here in Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when death will come to a man, to them, when death will come to him, he will say, قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ. Oh Allah, give me a chance to come back. رَبِّ ارْجِعُونَ لَعَلِّي أَعْمِلُ صَالِحًا. أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا. I promise to work righteousness. I promise to pray. I promise to fast. I promise to read the Quran. Just bring me back. You had a chance. You have a chance now. Why are you wasting your time? Why are you not praying? Why are you not reading the Quran? Why not within hijab? It's your turn right now. قَالَ رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِ لَعَلِّي أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ. كَلَّا. It shall not happen. And at the end of Surah Al-Mu'minun, what did Allah start with Surah Al-Mu'minun? He started with? He started with? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ. He started with? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And he ends with? Do you know what he ends with, subhanahu wa ta'ala? لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. The non-believers? لَا يُفْلِحُونَ. Subhanallah. The mu'min, which are you, inshaAllah ta'ala, you will be successful. And the non-believers, may Allah forbid, may Allah save us all, they shall not be successful in the day of judgment. May Allah Azza wa Jalla help us and reward us, and may Allah Azza wa Jalla guide us to the best of this world, of the dunya, and the world of the akhirah. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.